Elmo's 132, so he's been playing through this. Find one more mushroom, we'd have that one done. Or an anomaly. I don't see any anomalies on the map either. I'm gonna go up this east side and see if I can find any. Here's the anomaly. One's right here. Done with everything now. Did you find any of your chest?
No, I've been
farming.
Well, I've been looking for crystals.
Oh.
But it really hasn't. I've really come across any houses or anything. Let's see, there's a fucking mansion off in the distance.
Yeah, I'm not seeing anything in this one. Nothing in this place. Completely empty. There's two crystals right here. You looking for quartz?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's two right here behind me. In the water. Look at some of these other weapons and see if there's anything looks interesting. Headshots cause explosions. One hit splinters.
Keep an eye on your objectives. Smash it, grab it, and get ready to run. We're heading home.
Snares. Affliction. Get off me. I got a survivor over here. There we go. Survivors. That's crazy. 903 survivors left to go.
Nice.
Sheesh. I told myself about a year ago that I was never going to do that or the play with others. And here I am still playing the game.
Yeah.
I've
still got freaking 3,000 left to do, like 2,900.
Yeah.
Like, I never, like, have fucking worried about survivors. But probably, I don't know, I guess, like, in the past 6 months, I've just started being more conscious about it, at least, and it's almost...
I mean, it's just something to do, something to work toward anyway, you know what I mean? After you've gotten everything else done.
Yep.
Let's see if there's a chest down here for you.
I got one.
This timer ran out. I didn't realize it was that close. Well, that was an easy match.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I did find one chest anyhow.
That's good. It's something at least. I went over to BR and got that blinding lights emote a while ago. You know, since we got him in here, did you happen to look and see if there was a four Atlas? I didn't pay no attention.
It's not.
It's like you really get me.
Hey.
I wish you could convert the XP that you're not using to something else somehow in some way, form, or fashion. You know what I mean? Like, I have 61 million schematic XP. I have almost 50 million hero XP. I've got over 100 million survivor XP. I don't know. I mean, I'd be happy with gold. Just convert it to gold. You know what I mean? Just, that'd be cool. But, whatever. Yeah, there's no four Atlas. No four. Oh, wait, there's... Oh, that's a 108.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that just sucks. We could be getting that done. I guess I'll switch to my constructor now. And You want to do the trap, the 140 trap? That'll give you time to look around, and I can build up, and you can look for your chest. Wall weakening, it's water, life leech. Look, I don't remember what the other one is. Oops.
Don't tell me what's inside. I want it to be a surprise.
Starting to get hungry. Let's see if I got something I can throw in the oven right quick.
Man! Oh, I'm chips and dips a little bit warm.
To looking at my guns. And this one sucks. I'm gonna get rid of it. I tried to make a way for the nailer, the nail gun, to be a cool gun, and I just don't see it. It's so weak.
And it's too obnoxious to shoot.
I don't need this. What else? Hey, chill. Chill, I'm trying to look at my inventory. Get off of me. There's some shadow. I don't need it. Yeah, that Freedom's Herald's pretty fun. I like that.
This looks like Let's set up here. Like, yeah, another favorite of mine is the Zap Zap.
I don't know, something about that one, for some reason I just didn't like it. I don't know if it's, well, I mean, the first time I played it too, you know, I had a crit build on it, and it shoots so incredibly slow. Reload slow.
Yeah, but it shoots like it's got a area, the area effects like a rocket launcher. It's like pretty much like a faster shooting rocket launcher.
Yeah, so just high damage.
Mm-hmm.
What's in this vending machine? Oh, another Old Smoky. Let's try it. What's it gonna give me on this one? Wow, it's got a lot of damage. Let's try it out. There's an encampment right here. Yeah, that's pretty cool too. This one's got that base damage to stunned or
So
knock and make her stunning, 12 base damage.
So I got me another sod buster earlier.
Yeah.
And I noticed that on the sod busters it has the 25 impact and 400 knockback magnitude.
Oh, it does, huh?
And you can also put 4 impacts on it.
Yeah, for real?
With no impacts.
I bet you could send them flying with that thing. That would be crazy.
With no impacts, it's 60,000. Like 59,000 with no impacts.
Yeah, so that could possibly be the most impact gun. Like, it'd probably be the Dam Buster and the Santa's Helper, couldn't it?
Yeah, Dam Buster's only like, with impact on it, it's only like 30,000 or something like that.
Yeah, it used to be back in the day. It used to be one of the strongest ones back when, the game first came out. But
no, it still is. Like, but like you could have a hunt. Like I want to get one so bad. Like that's the next thing I'm gonna pull out my collection book and make. This I want to need another.
The Sod Buster or the.
Yeah, Sod Buster. I need another perk. Thing change perk. 6 perk on it. Yep. Unless I just happen to get lucky and pull one out with it.
Yeah. I might try that out. That'd be fun to play with. I mean, hell, with something right. That high of an impact, man, you could throw smashes around like it was nothing.
Yeah, any level smashes.
Yeah.
It would literally be a broom. Like a high-powered broom.
Yeah, that sounds cool. I'll have to check into that. I already have one. I mean, if I get a core perk, I might just change the one I got. Because I haven't been making it, you know what I mean? I just, I don't know.
Yeah, if you got some legendary flux, fuck yeah.
You can't see the flux from here, can you? No. Have to wait till we get out of this match.
Maybe, it's a 3-second reload speed. So, like, I'd want all 4 impacts. I look, there's not even another weapon that you can put 3 impacts on. Or nothing that's of high impact anyways.
I'm not even doing the objective. I've been running around killing stuff.
Me too.
Just playing with guns.
What is the objective? Oh.
The traps.
Oh, yeah.
I do have 3 blue glow already, though. I guess I'll wait and get me another blue glow and then go do it. Survivor. I wonder how long that one was going to take. Oh, there's a blue glow right there. I'll go build after this. Does it matter which one we do first?
So you want to do the mansion first and then the castle? And so
this one, he's got half the building blown up already.
Yeah. Yep, and all you do on these is you just push them in that hole, top in the hole, and once it gets started.
Yeah.
And
I did something to you earlier.
Yep.
Ice storm. Craft some wall launchers real quick. You got a wall. You got a wall blocking
yeah,
you there.
I threw that wall up as the building was falling and it got stuck.
Here, we'll do this. Put this in here, and then we'll make it where they can't stay there very long. That should do it. Hey, what's in this vending machine? Black metal rocket launcher, crowbar, and the black metal pistol. Alright. I guess we're ready to start this one, aren't we? Over here, guys, follow me. Hitting an enemy with this weapon grants 6% movement speed for 5 seconds. Bendertech Slammer.
I love making smashers charge off the map. It's freaking hilarious.
Well, that was easy enough. Next. Eliminating three enemies with this weapon reduces current health. Oh, that's the basic. What's this one? Affliction. Alright, I guess I'll run up here to the next one. Oh yeah, this is the easy one right here, I think. Because they can't come up on this side. They only have this ramp and then through the building that they can come in.
No,
Huh?
The building, that shouldn't be an issue.
Yeah, they'll come through the building sometimes.
No, like, what I'm saying is, like, take the building out.
Oh, like, I use it just to block them. I mean,
No, well, I meant, like, the parts that, that they can climb up. Yeah, the parts that they use to get up. The easiest way to do it is we usually come in with a soldier, or like carbide or something. You just take the whole building out and just build a couple, simple traps, push them in the hole and get in that hole. And, they'll jump in there.
Yeah. How about if I do this? They're all falling straight down. That's lovely.
We need to deploy the track before time runs out.
Okay, Ray, chill. I think we pretty well got this side taken care of with the delays. Should be no problem here. Hey, look on that side.
Alright.
All right.
It's working. Keep the track safe until the storm is completely contained. Can't do nothing. Nothing.
Get off me. Let's just do this. Thank you. Alright. Do you know when the weekly reset is? Well, like what day they reset on?
Wednesdays. It used to be Thursdays, but it's Wednesdays now.
Okay. I wasn't
Wednesdays
sure.
At 7. Well, 7 o'clock my time.
Alright. When they once they started, ever since they went into out of early access, I haven't known when they actually reset the week. I never really paid attention, so. Because I haven't been playing Save the World that much, so other than just the ventures, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, it's Wednesdays at 7, and it may go back to being that there's a time change coming up. It could just be due to time change. Like it used to be at 6, 7, and it could go back to 6, maybe. So you get a level 6 chest from doing that.
Take it out west. Yep. Joe did.
Yep. Yeah, and you get... But you gotta do the mansion and then the castle.
Okay.
So that's what I'm made of.
So, there's an encampment one.
Sure.
I'm gonna switch heroes though. Maybe, yeah. Gadgeteer. I'll go to Gadgeteer. Over troops. Actually, no. I know what I want to do. I want to play with... I hadn't played with this other Outlander in a while. I got one set up for Seismic Smash to where I could use it over and over and over and over and over.
What? I just set one up for that.
I'm using the guy in full red. The fault. He's got fault line. Decreases seismic.
Can you guard Southie?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, Vanguard Selfie.
And I've got Kamor Mora. And
who's
then
that? Oh, the guy from Battlebreakers.
Yep, and it's still Wool Anthony. Like, I just made this. I was like, I want a Seismic Smash loadout. And do space technology and sustained smash.
I'm using Blast from the Past on it for health, and then for the energy too as well. So I'm using, you know, the Outlander for energy, and which was Fossil Southie, the Syrian Instinct abilities heal health, and then sustained smash, which is when you are using the seismic stun, which is the one you're using, and then I'm using Pressing Charges, which is the Deco Llama, because it increases damage to fragment abilities 30%. So it all pretty much either heals me or gives me more health or uses abilities.
You check out, okay, check your press X on Vanguard Southie on your main and go to abilities, and I want to see how much difference is that ability energy, the having that one chick in does.
Go to abilities.
Yeah, if you press X and then click your right stick over to abilities, it'll show your damage for the seismic smash.
I'm not getting that. Like,
in your hero loadout.
I'm in the hero loadout.
Just press X on your main hero, Vanguard Southie. And then
when I press X on it, it wants me to swap it to something. It brings up the rest of the heroes to change them out. Upgrade, like upgrade inspect square? See all stats, L3? That's what you're talking about, okay.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Well, I forget you're on computer.
I'm on PlayStation.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so you want to look at what now? The
abilities.
Abilities.
Energy damage on your seismic smash. What does it say? The like at the top up there it says cooldown.